Today we're going to talk about what not to wear to the Kentucky Derby. Now, perhaps you've already watched my video on what to wear to the Kentucky Derby and have some additional questions. Chances are I will address your concerns here. There are some things not to wear because they simply are not allowed into Churchill Downs Racetrack. There are other things not to wear because they will be impractical or uncomfortable. And lastly, there are some subjective suggestions on what not to wear simply because it will look bad. First, let's start with what's not allowed into Churchill Downs Racetrack. You cannot bring an umbrella, did you know that? So if you had a parasol to coordinate with your outfit like I did one year, you can't bring it into the racetrack, so you're either gonna have to throw it out before you enter or ask someone who's working at a kiosk outside the racetrack to hold onto it for you and you can pick it up after you leave. Although these don't necessarily fall into the wearing category, I still think they're worth mentioning. The racetrack won't allow you to bring in selfie sticks, luggage, backpacks, or animals. Sorry, dog lovers. As cute as it might sound, you can't dress your chihuahua in a cute pantsuit and fascinator and expect to get into Churchill Downs. Don't do it, because it won't happen. Next, what's going to be impractical or uncomfortable? You might think I'm gonna say high heels, but I'm not. Go ahead and wear your high heels. As long as you're not sitting in the infield, you should be just fine. One thing I will add is that you should really break them in before you wear them. Don't wear shoes for the first time at the Kentucky Derby. If you're worried about blisters, this might sound strange, but consider coating your feet in deodorant before you put your shoes on, because that will greatly cut down on friction. Bring plenty of mini Band-Aids just in case, because we've all been there. Once you start blistering on your feet, you're a goner. Again, this is subjective, but I'm going to recommend something. Don't wear one of those old-fashioned floppy-brimmed hats with lots of feathers and crazy things going on top of them. There are a few reasons why. The first being that it's just out of style. These hats were maybe interesting in the 80s, maybe the 90s, but it's just not the style that people wear anymore, and it tends to look very costumey. And second, they are extremely impractical for photos. When you have a large brim extending over your forehead, it shades your face, and you won't even see yourself showing up in any pictures. Do not wear anything that you think might work in a nightclub. This is a daytime event, not an after-hours affair. Although it's a huge, huge party, don't get me wrong, it's really not the place to work that LBD sexy clubbing dress look. That's not to say that you can't look cute and wear a dress that's above the knee, but keep it feminine, playful, and fun. Wearing a nightclubby dress will only drive home the point that you've never been to the Kentucky Derby before and had no idea how to dress. And lastly, do not wear nothing on your head. This might seem obvious, but I have to say, every year at the Kentucky Derby, there's at least 5 people who don't wear a hat. Maybe they don't want to because they think they'll feel uncomfortable in a hat. But let me tell you, there's nothing more uncomfortable than being one of only a few people at Churchill Downs not wearing a hat. You really will stick out like a sore thumb. It just looks out of place. Next, we'll go over the difference between hats, fascinators, hair jewelry, headbands, and hatinators. So stay tuned. And please check out my online boutique, chapeau.com, and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more fashion tips.